How can Formula One ideas be applied to today's MotoGP bikes? There was the tune Mass Damper, used by Renault F1 team, that has found its way into MotoGP as an example. Recent developments on MotoGP bikes have gone into aerodynamic dynamics. Ducati has been experimenting with front and rear downforce to have some control of its center of pressure movement. Its rear downforce setup has wing elements mounted under the swing arm. Even though Ducati Corsa says it's to cool the tires, it looks to actually provide downforce on the rear section of the bike. This is to reduce center of pressure moving forward under heavy braking. That would also reduce rear wheel lift and reduced rear lateral movement. This reduction can also ask for more braking performance, as it would help reduce the risk of the bike tilting over. So which technology in Formula One can be applied here to improve rear downforce exclusively for heavy braking? Maybe the blown diffuser could help. Blown diffuser was introduced to Formula One after the FIA banned double diffuser. Double diffuser takes airflow from the underfloor of an F1 car to go over the top section via some loopholes, literally. It was very effective. With it banned, teams tried to recover downforce loss by using exhaust pressure to blow the top section of the diffuser. Blown diffuser uses a similar system to a turbo anti-lag ignition delay setup, but instead of having the exhaust blowing a turbocharger, it blows a diffuser instead, improving downforce. Since it works like a turbo anti-lag setup, this means it works during off to mild throttle openings, so it can be used to its full potential during braking, applying itself to a MotoGP's bike braking package. Fins can be mounted on the swing arm, where when the rear suspension is on droop, these fins will drop into the path of the exhaust outlet when braking. Then the blown exhaust will be triggered to blow those fins, giving more rear downforce under heavy braking. Under acceleration, MotoGP bikes will be on full anti-wheelie mode. This means a lot of weight is on the rear suspension, causing it to compress and raise those fins above the path of the exhaust, not hampering its airflow. This time around though, if the FIM wants to crack down on swing arm downforce, the rear tire cooling excuse may not be sufficient to convince scrutineers. To take this into the realm of silly, how about using the exhaust flow to blow those front wings instead? Those front wings are there to keep the front down so more power can be applied during acceleration. An exhaust can be made to blow a front wing, and then during deceleration it would do the opposite of the blown swing arm and stall the front wings, as under braking it can do better without front downforce. This, of course, is around the concept that the front wing must rely on exhaust gas velocity to work and is designed to stall when there is minimal exhaust gas velocity. Varying ratio downforce pitch setup, such as flexible wings and also rake changes by aerodynamic loads in downforce, is used by F1 teams. This changes the angle of attack of F1 car's downforce aero elements. At low speed, it tries to get as much downforce as possible, and angles are steep. Then when speed increases, the angle of attack of these downforce elements would yield to the oncoming high-speed airload, reducing its angle and how much downforce the wing can generate, allowing for higher speeds on flat-out sections of a racing track. The higher downforce setup, the more effect it had. This philosophy can be adapted to a MotoGP bike. As mentioned before, front wings on a MotoGP bike is to keep the front from lifting off the ground by applying downforce to it. The bike's wheelbase and center of gravity is overwhelmed by its power and traction. Holding the front down will allow the rider to apply even more power. The problem here is when it comes to braking, entering, and corner apex. Front downforce only would exaggerate the center of pressure forward shift during hard braking. This would not be good for braking stability, especially when braking into a corner, as too much mass is forced forward, that it would be more of a challenge to keep the rear tire on the ground for lateral force stability. The angle of the front wing will be greater too during braking, as the bike would be pitching forward, exaggerating such a scenario. So the idea here would be to get more downforce ratio when the bike is accelerating, and then reduce it when it is decelerating and negotiating a corner. Of course, slow and fast out cornering would welcome front downforce. So how can this be done? We will be utilizing the front suspension and fender to get the variation. When a racing bike accelerates, the front wheel droop, opening up space between the front wheel and triple clamp. If there was an air scoop behind this area, behind the front wheel and triple clamp, that redirects air to the front wing of a bike, the channeled air would be designed to create or make even more downforce at the front. It may even be designed to have a front wing that is dependent on the system and ineffective when there is no supply of air from the system. It could work like the F-duct system that channels air from a scoop to the rear wing, reducing downforce and drag, or like the double DRS that channels air from the rear wing to the front wing to stall the front wing when DRS is applied, hence double DRS. On the bike, when it reaches its final gears that won't lift the front wheel anymore, certain sections of the air passage that is accessible to the rider can be made flexible for the rider to close it. This would stop air flowing to the front wings and reduce downforce and drag to get a better top speed. When braking, where we do not want downforce, the front wheel travel is minimum as the suspension is compressed. Its fender would then block airflow towards the scoop. This would starve the system of air to the front wing, reducing both downforce and center of pressure forward shift, improving braking ability that the bike is less likely to tilt over under heavy braking, and stability for corner entry while still under braking or brake trail. Transition into a corner, the centrifugal force would continue to force compression on the suspension. This would continue to starve the front wing, keeping unnecessary downforce away from multiplying on the bike's cornering G-forces. This dynamism would bring advantages of having a front wing and reduced its disadvantages. With a little help from ideas used in Formula One before.